So we don't have to put, say, philosophical tenets in a different category from other things. We often accept that, okay, you may not be able to follow this particular rule, you may not be able to accept this cultural aspect, but somehow we don't make that into a faith issue. But when we are unable to accept something intellectually, sometimes we make that into a faith issue. Oh, you are having doubts. So it seems that we could have a more accommodating and understanding approach, not just to somebody's difficulty in practicing a particular rule or a particular standard, but also difficulty in accepting a particular philosophical proposition or philosophical tenet also.
Yes, I think we can only make progress from where we are. One of my favorite kind of theological jokes is the thing from Ireland where if you ask someone, how do you get to Kilkenny? And they'll say, ah, no, I wouldn't start from here. But where else can you start from?
Beautiful.
We can only start our journey in Krishna consciousness from where we are. We can only ever take our next step from where we are. I wish I was further down the path of Krishna consciousness. I wish I had greater realizations on so many other aspects, but I'm not there yet, and therefore I've got to proceed from where I am. And I think we've all got to be very comfortable with that, and to take great comfort, encouragement, and gratitude for the realizations that each one of us already have in our spiritual life. And use that as the strength, the determination to want to progress further. And all things kind of can come to be revealed. Over the early years in late 70s, early 80s, I had a little association with Satipata Prabhu. Not a lot, but what I did have did impact me. And one of the things that I imbibed from him was that in the science field, where there are either statements in the Bhagavatam that seem to not run parallel or consistent with what, say, modern science would say, we don't get hung up on that one and we don't worry about it, but we don't necessarily just compromise either in our minds, but we just think, there's something more that I need to understand about both. I need to understand exactly what the science is about, and I need to know exactly what Krishna consciousness is saying. And not just to make a very quick assumption, oh, this doesn't tally with what I think each of them means. So that was something I got from Satipata, and it's always stayed with me that we have to deepen our understanding, both of what we understand within Krishna consciousness and also what we understand science can say and is saying about something in particular. So I think that we've always got, where there are issues that seem to cause controversy in our minds, relax. We will come to them. We progress along those things that we are confident on in our spiritual path. And if we do the right study and if we do it carefully and objectively, it's amazing the sort of realizations and that come to us in due course.